This man right here is the greatest warrior America has ever seen.
Think of this, though. We're just one day away. Oh, we've been waiting for this. I've been waiting 4 years for this. And so have you. And so have you. We've all been waiting 4 years. One day. The ball is in our hand. We're at the 2-yard line, maybe the 1-yard line. But it's in our hand, and we put it over that. It'll be the biggest event maybe in the history of our country. And let me... Kamala, you're fired. Get the hell out of here. You're fired. November 5th, 2024 will be Liberation Day in America. And on day one, I will launch the largest deportation program of criminals in American history. We're going to get them out. We have to. I will invoke the Alien Enemies Act of 1798. You know, 1798, that's when they ran the country a little tougher than we run it today. Today, you get a little slap in the wrist when you kill somebody. You kill somebody. Oh. And I'm hereby calling for the death penalty for any migrant that kills an American citizen or a law enforcement officer. Her whole life, she's against anything coming out of the ground. She likes the wind, you know, the wind. It kills all your birds. That doesn't work. That's the most expensive energy in the entire world. And then after 10 years, when it rusts out, they don't look too good. In 1 year from January 20th, which would be the day we take over. Oh, it's so close. It's so close, but still dangerous. The ball's in our court. You know, as they say in athletics, the ball is in our court. All we have to do is get out and vote, and we walk away with the greatest political event in history. But much more important, it's going to be the event that saves our country. We are going to fire Kamala, and we are going to save America. And I will stop the chaos in the Middle East. There's another thing, Israel. October 7th. October 7th would have never happened. All of those people that were hostages hopefully are still, because I hope they're of hostage. I just hope they haven't been killed, but I think a lot of them are killed. I think a lot of them have been killed, but we can hope again. And we will make America great again. Thank you, everybody. Thank you. Thank you, Pennsylvania. We'll be back.
But what you all are signing up to do today and what you've been doing, like, let's enjoy it. You know, and I know you do. I can feel the mood in here because it's the best of who we are as a democracy. And so the way I've always been thinking about our campaign in these next 24 hours is, as we are getting out the vote, as we are canvassing, let's be intentional about building community. About building community, about building coalitions, about reminding people we all have so much more in common than what separates us. So over these next 24 hours, I know everyone is here, including our youngest leaders. I see you over there. I know you're not ready to vote because you look like you're about 8. But you tell the adults in your life why it's important. They vote, okay? I have the blessing of being able to travel around our country. And I'm telling you guys, we're good. We're good. We're good. We really are. We're going to keep doing this work with the optimism that it requires to be strong. Everyone here knows, in the context of your family, in your life, when you believe something is possible, You put in the hard work, and you know it's good work. Hard work is good work. It's joyful work, and we get the job done. Let's get this done. Thank you all.